Hello, in this tutorial, I'm going to be talking about tectonic plates and trying to help you see how one tectonic plate can have two types of crust on it, including continental crust and oceanic crust. The map that we're looking at is from USGS, and it's a global map of all of the tectonic plates. Each is outlined in black and shown in a different color. And there are red arrows that show you how the plate is moving at that location along its edge. If we start by looking at the Pacific plate, it's this light yellow plate. Now, most of this plate is oceanic crust, and that it's at the bottom of the Pacific Ocean. It makes up a large part of the Pacific Ocean. And if we look very closely at a very small portion of it along the edge of California, it has a tiny sliver of continental crust, and that's where it's up high out of the ocean. And so it's mostly oceanic crust, but at this location, it has a tiny little bit of continental crust. That one's kind of an easier plate to see because it's mostly one type, but other plates are two types. And if we look over at the African plate, we can see that the continent of Africa is made out of continental crust, and it's shown in this kind of light peach color. And then down where it's darker peach or maybe orange, depending on your computer screen, this is where we have oceanic crust. So on this part, we have oceanic crust, and then Madagascar and Africa are going to be continental crust. So if we look at the next plate, if we look at the North American plate, we can see that it is about half continental crust and half oceanic crust. The part that's in the Atlantic Ocean Basin is oceanic crust, and the part that makes up the continents that we can go and fly to and walk around on top of, this is going to be that continental crust, and Greenland would also be part. So we can kind of see that. Now, some questions that students have are trying to understand where the edges of the plates are and how the plates can be moving in different directions at different places. If we take a look at this boundary between the North American plate and the Eurasian plate, we can see this is right in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, so we have oceanic crust, and the arrows are moving away from each other. So this is a divergent plate boundary. The plate is moving away, okay? Now, the North American plate, also keep in mind that these are moving on a curved surface, not a flat map like we're looking at here. The North American plate kind of moves, it's away from the mid-oceanic ridge in the Atlantic Ocean, and it's coming over and towards the Pacific plate. Along this boundary where we see the Juan de Fuca plate and this part of the Pacific plate, we actually have a convergent plate boundary. The plates are coming together, and that's because this is moving over and colliding into this edge. So on that sense, it's a convergent plate boundary. Now down here in California, we have a very famous transform plate boundary. And that actually is where the San Andreas Fault is located. And in this portion, where these two plates come together, they're actually sliding past each other. Okay? It can be a little confusing, but you have to keep in mind that the plates are rotating on a globe, a round surface, and in some places they'll move away from each other, and other places on the opposite side they'll start to collide, but there will be some edges where the plates actually do have to just slide past each other as they're moving. Let's take a look at another example. If we look down at the South American plate, what type of crust would we see in this location? Hopefully you said continental. And over here we would see oceanic crust. Okay, again, we're in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, so we have a divergent plate boundary. The South American plate is moving to the left, and the African plate is moving to the right. Now over here, the South American plate is still moving to the left, and it's colliding with the Nazca plate. This is making a very long, distinct convergent plate boundary, and it would have a large oceanic trench down at that location. Okay, now down here, it's not actually showing it, but we would start to see some transform plate boundaries because the plates are moving this way, and the Scotia plates can be moving a little bit in one direction, so we'll start to see some transform activity. So that's just hopefully will help you understand the differences between crust type on individual lithospheric plates and how the plate boundaries relates to plate motion. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask.